Hey guys, it's Lokai coming at you with a really short video to help you through the Buu Buu Majin Buu mission. In this mission, you are tasked with taking on multiple Buus at the same time and helping Super Saiyan 3 Goku. So let's talk about the mission a little bit real quick, and we'll kind of show you some tricks to get through it. So this mission has you tasked with taking on 3 Majin Buus at the beginning, helping Super Saiyan 3 Goku. And once those are dealt with, Goku leaves, and he kind of leaves you high and dry facing a ton of smaller, weaker Buus. So this is where the whole thing gets a little bit complicated. You're kind of tasked with taking on so many of these, and people don't know if you have to kill them all, and they keep respawning. You just have to outlast them. And so there are a few tactics involving running around or dodging, but I want to show you the one I use. It shouldn't be too difficult, but let's talk about your setup first. First of all, you'll want to be around level 35 to take on this mission. The highest level character in this is level 37. The small Buus are level 35, though, so that's something that shouldn't be too hard to attain. But let's go straight into our equipment. Again, you can use whatever gear you want. I use the elite suit permanently. It's just part of this guy's outfit. I probably won't be changing it anytime soon. This is the big change for this, which is a new Z-Soul, which is from PQ15, and now Gohan drops this. And it is a very, very good Z-Soul. You will use this a few times throughout the lifespan of the game. It's very, very useful in the Bardock mission as well. What does it do? Well, it basically recharges your entire key bar every time you kill someone. So in a mission like this, every time you kill one of those weak fat Buus, you'll get an instant ability to pop another Ultra. So the idea is to be able to pop multiple Ultras back to back and continually keep the Buus off of you as they respawn. As for skills, I've changed some things a little bit, not too terribly much. I replaced Big Bang with Perfect Shot, which is from the Perfect Cell training. Death Beam, of course, being from Frieza's training, which you get by finishing Ginyu's training, and then Frieza will show up. Again, it's RNG, so you might have little issues. This is Super Drain. I forget the exact PQ it's from, but I'll leave it in the annotation so you know where to get it. This basically replaces Rise to Action. It grabs the enemy and drains 3 of their stamina bars, makes the enemy less likely to dodge or vanish, or use their evasive. Of course, the debate is, does the AI even have stamina? We don't really know yet. I think they do, but they just regenerate really, really super fast. So there's that. It is a striking move, but it drains the same amount of stamina no matter what. So then we move on to Death Ball. Again, I forget the exact PQ this comes from, but I know you have access to it now. I'll leave that PQ in the annotations. This is a nice little thematic move I'm using. Final Flash is still, I think, a little bit better than that. And of course, Ultra Flaming Bomber and Super Explosive Wave, which is an upgrade from what I was using. As for stats, as you can see, I have leveled myself up. I now have 100 in my Ki Blasts, and I'm starting to build up my stamina. Of course, I choose to stack stamina because if I don't have stamina, as you saw in the 17 video, I can't actually use my Ultras. So it's important to have a lot of stamina. In fact, I debated whether I should stack stamina first or damage. I went damage. Some people will say split it between the two. I chose to just drop it all in damage. It's been working so far. We'll see if it keeps working or not. And so that is the setup. That is what we're going to be doing. I will go over tactics and why I do the things I do as the fight plays out. And hopefully this will help you guys with this mission. Again, I didn't have too many issues when I got here. So hopefully it's just a matter of, you know, not understanding what you had to do in the mission, which is the big one. I think I failed it a couple of times before I got it, but let's get right on into it, and we'll see just how this mission plays out. Hey guys, it's Lokai again. So this is the what not to do during this fight. So I make a few mistakes that are kind of costly, and I'll point them out to you. And I'll also point out the abilities to look out for. So the first ability he has is his evasive. It's just annoying. He dashes away. He does a little bit of damage to it. He also has this little dark charge he does. All the dark characters have it. Again, it just staggers you. It's just kind of annoying. I told you to AoE burn them. I'm under the impression that's not the best way to go. The reason is, they hit kind of hard. And if you aggro two of them like I do, there's a good chance you're just going to get your butt handed to you. So, yeah, it's probably better to just focus on one. Let Goku tank two of them. He's perfectly capable of tanking two of them. In fact, he could probably tank all three of them without our help. I get the feeling we're really not needed in this first phase. So, yeah, that's what I would do. There's not much to say about this first phase. I'm just going to end it here. I'll let you guys watch the rest of this fight so you can see all of my mistakes, including where I just about die. I honestly don't know how I healed myself. It's coming up here in a moment. I'll stick around until then. But yeah, it's not too terribly bad. You'll see it here. He'll start countering me. He'll hit me a few times, and I don't know how I got that heal off, but I did. I should have died there, honestly. So yeah, I'll pop over. I'll pick back up and talk to you guys when you get to the second phase, which is the one that most people have issues with. Once you kill that last Majin Buu, prep yourself. Goku's going to talk about reaching his limit. He's going to take off, and you're going to be attacked by five small Majin Buus. Individually, they're still pretty durable. That's kind of their thing. They have a real high damage reduction, I believe. Other than that, they're not really tough. They don't have any new moves of what to speak of. They're just, you know, there's just a bunch of them. The basic tactic here is to keep moving, keep mobile until you get your ultimate. And then you kind of want to fly into the middle of them and pop your ultra. Keep in mind, you do need stamina before you pop that. If you don't have it, you're going to end up without stamina, and they're just going to have a heyday with you. It's still a lot harder than it sounds. The other thing to keep in mind is this is not a, you know, kill them all victory. This is literally last so long. You have to stay alive until Trunks starts talking. And he'll convince Majin Buu to wait, and then the whole thing ends. You're going to see the Z-Soul I told you to equip in action here in just a moment, and you'll see why it's so good in these missions. So you see he's almost dead. I pop it. I kill two of them. I immediately have max key bars again. You know, I kind of attack this guy just to buy some time. Now they're all around me again. I pop it again. I kill another one. I immediately have full stamina or key bars again. And I'm going to do it again. Immediately have full key bars again. You can see where this is going, right? This is why this Z-Soul is so good. It will win you the Bardock fight every single time. That is the key to winning that fight. But it also works really well here. And here we have Trunks talking to Majin Buu. So the finish signifies this fight is over. And I've, you know, managed to survive. If you die while he's telling his speech, though, it will fail you. So, it's yeah, don't die. That's why I healed up there, because they will keep attacking you during his speech. So, and there we have it. It's over, and done. So that's the mission, and I hope it has helped you out. I hope this tactic will help you get past this. If you guys have any questions, feel free to post them in the comments section. You can send me a private message if you want to ask me something personally. If you like this and you want to see more, please like and subscribe. While we try to get our